Good afternoon to one and all present here. On behalf of Visual Communication Department, I am Shakti, extending a hearty welcome to all who have gathered here for the workshop and story writing on Clipart on the Department of Visual Communication of Science and Humanities, SRMIST Vadapalani campus conveys its greeting to each and everyone who are spending your valuable time with us. I welcome all who would have liked to thank our Director, Academic Dr. K. Subram, SRMIST, Vadapalani Viscom campus, and Dean Dr. K. Ananta Padmanabhan, CHS, SRMIST, Vadapalani campus, for initiative support and encouraging throughout the academic. Without their support, today's event is now possible. And I'm really excited, looking forward to acquire and learn the depth and the story writing board Clipart. Now I like to introduce Director K Subram sir, SRMIST Vadapalani campus, who would like to deliver a special address.
Yes. Thank you. Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Yeah, is it clear? Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible, sir.
Okay. We have our distinguished guest, Ms. Raisa Bastian, Art Director and Visual Art and Visual Director, faculty members of Visual Communication, and beloved students. It is a workshop on storyboard and concept art. As I have been mentioning in several meetings, visual communication is a functional subject and the creativity play a major role, and all the students should develop this skill, the creative skill that is very, very important for this subject. Now, coming to this part, this topic, each and every area is very important in visual communication, and this is one area that is storyboard and the concept art. You know, it is a graphic designer. The images displays in sequence for the purpose of pre-visualizing a motion picture. That's what I have learned for this. This storyboard will help us to understand it's a very important part of pre-production process. The student should know that this is a very important part of pre-production process because it clearly conveys how the story will flow. So that is the purpose here, and that is important of this storyboard. And coming to the concept art, you know, it is a form of visual art to convey an idea for use in films. Not only in film, video games, animation, to show the project progress to the directors. So that is the concept art. So this, both these things are very important areas in visual communication. Here, the creativity and other skills are playing important role. I used to say in several meetings, skill. Here also, you have some skill. Then, coming to the, what do you understand by storyboard? A series of drawings or illustrations. That is a storyboard. It's a series of drawings and illustration. It helps a person visualize a story without compromising on details. That is the significant. That is the thing you will know, you will understand by storyboard. I'll repeat, it's a series of drawings. It helps a person visualize a story without compromising the details. Then you can ask one question. Then what is the importance of storyboard in animation? Yeah, in animation also it plays a major role. It defines the parameters of the story within the required resources and time. This is very, very important. Students should understand. Within the required resources and time, You have to show the parameters of the story. And it is for the smooth production process. Even for animation, it will help for smooth production process. We have a very dynamic person now today, Ms. Reisa Bastian. And she's going to explain in detail. I'm not a subject expert. And coming to the story artist, the story artist creates strong board for ad agencies also. That's what I came to know. You know, you should remember the famous storyboard artist in 1960s. A famous storyboard artist, Saul Bass, S-A-U-L, Saul Bass, B-A-S-S. Very famous artist, storyboard artist. So right from 1960, this storyboard has been there in film industry, not only in film, but also in other. Then the significance in HTML or CSS, significance of storyboard in HTML and CSS is also playing a major role. That means it visualizes large graphic projects, layout, design of your entire website. So HTML and CSS also, the storyboard is playing important role. Only thing, the student should develop interest. Then only you can be expert in each and every area of visual communication. It's a wide area. Then coming to the concept art. A concept art also helps to convey the look, face, and mood of your design. Not only it conveys the look alone, feel, and mood of your design or idea. It is used to capture and convey the overall design vision of your project. So the concept art will give overall design vision of the art. Now, when you see the important part of the concept art is simple idea or concept. Just idea or concept is the important part of concept art. Then coming to the function of concept art, what is the main function? It helps align the creatives working on projects, that's all. Just aligning the creatives working on the project. So these two things are very important, and it is also playing a major role in contemporary art. Concept art is also playing a major role in contemporary art. I think the guest will explain about the contemporary art in detail, need for contemporary art. That means a very simple, it means of personal expression. Personal expression is the contemporary art. So these are all the skills you will develop. A very important field. And we have a very dynamic person. With these few words, what I know about this subject, I take this opportunity to wish you all success in this workshop. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your address. Good afternoon, everyone. I profusely overjoyed to take this opportunity to introduce our guest of honor, Ms. Reisa Bastian, who is currently working as a game and visual designer in Big Fat Phoenix Interactive. Some of her inspirational works includes working in Adobe Photoshop as an imaging associate or converter. She then managed her own boutique named Kitan with her own designing ideas. She also did freelancing as a graphic designer. In 2018, she worked as a game designer in Baiju Think and Learn Private Limited. She did a bachelor degree in visual arts in Stella Maris, Chennai, and a master degree in digital game design in National Institute of Design. She has also completed a diploma in multimedia and animation in 2014. I feel extremely happy to have such a great personality with us today. It's a great honor to have you, admin sirs. Once again, hearty welcome, ma'am. Thank you.
Ma'am,
yes, Manoj. Yeah. Am I audible, ma'am?
Yes. Can you hear me?
Yes, madam. Yes, yes.
Hello, everyone. Yeah, hi. That was a very lovely introduction. I'm super honored to be here. My own creative director at my company is from SRM, so it feels like a whole circle coming back together. I guess like my introduction is covered by y'all. I'll just give you a better description of what I do currently. I work with Big Fat Phoenix, and we work on social emotional learning, educational games for children, which is and our market is in the US. But we play test and everything in India. And it's mostly, and we try to teach them all of those things through games, of course. Right. So my part over here is to be the visual designer. So whenever we come up with a concept, I'll be the one to translate all of those concepts into visuals and try and get those things moving and get it approved and see if it's viable, if it's doable, all of those things. So it'll be great to talk about my journey on how I, you know, worked with characters and composition and backgrounds and everything, and how it can all be put together in storyboards. I also had the honor in working with your amazing professor, Manoj, on multiple short films. And so we also worked on storyboards over there. So this will be good. And I also expect this to be a very interactive session, not just me talking. I also expect you students to talk, you know, ask me questions, and it should be a back and forth. I hope that can happen.
Yeah, ma'am, sure.
Great. Should I start?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, you can start.
Okay, going to screen share now. Just a second. Can you all see my screen?
Yes, it's clear. It's clear.
Awesome. Cool. Let's begin. So what I plan on focusing in this entire session is to talk about story, right? It's when you're talking about storyboarding, it's not just about drawing. It's also to understand what your story is about. And only then can you visualize it and actually put it on paper. And the theme of your story and your characters, backgrounds, and concepts and references. I will rush through them as much as possible, but I sincerely think each of these things are very important. So please have patience with me. Yeah, cool. So story, right? Exactly like what Mr. Subbaram, director, said, right? Storyboard for me is a way to visualize the entire movie in advance. So if you have a movie in place, the whole point of putting together a storyboard is to be able to visualize it beforehand. Because when you think about movies, right? Shooting a movie, putting together cameras, buying equipments, and everything, the whole setup is extremely expensive. So before you do all of that and make your mistake there, you need to put it together. It's better to put it together in a storyboard and visualize it for yourself, right? And when you talk about story, it starts in your mind. By that, I mean, I'll just give you an example, right? Let's say there is a person, a man named Akhil, right? He goes inside, he goes to the kitchen to make a cup of tea for his headache. This is my example, right? So how adha neenga eppadi ovvoru vaarthaya you have to visualize who is Akhil, right? Who is this man? So you have to visualize that character. And he goes inside the kitchen to make a cup of tea, right? So you have to imagine, is it his kitchen? Is it his friend's kitchen? Is it the office kitchen, right? Each and every single word of your story needs to be visualized, and it starts, and your storyboarding starts right there, right? So what was the sentence again? Yeah, Akhil goes to the kitchen to make himself a cup of tea for his headache, right? So now we also know that the man has a headache. So if you can see the second point, I mean, this kind of completes the story, right? So when I say he has a headache, immediately your scene, right? Your scene will start becoming a little dull, right? Your lighting changes because he has a headache. Your character, your main character has a headache. And your angle, your camera angle also slightly changes. Now it kind of goes down, right? To show how much of a stress he's in, right? And who is Mr. Akhil, right? Does that mean that he, is he a 40-year-old? Is he 70-year-old? Is he 5-year-old? All of, if you have your character complete, then that would make a difference in your scene. Imagine, okay, say you as a designer, you as the storyteller have decided that this man is going to be 40 years old. So immediately you can complete your, you can start your scene with him being, you know, an old man who, not, I mean, sorry, mid-ish, not that middle-aged man. And he's going inside and he's walking to the kitchen because he's stressed out about work or family or whatever. Say if he's 70, you make the decision as a storyteller that he's 70 years old or like, I don't know, wait, 98, 90 years old. Then you can imagine the scene going slower, right? You can imagine the panning going slower and slower because he's a much older man. So those are the importance in having each of those little aspects, each of those, every single word visualized, right? And a very important thing as a storyteller is to understand what you want your viewer to feel. அதாவது இப்ப நான் ஒரு மூவி எடுக்கிறேன்னா நான் ஒரு கதை எழுதுறேன் அது ஓகே தட்ஸ் ஃபைன் அது வெறும் கதையா இருக்க கூடாது ஹவ் வில் மை வியூவர் ஃபீல் இட்ஸ் நாட் ஜஸ்ட் அபவுட் நான் ஒரு பெயிண்டிங் இங்க பண்றேன்னா அந்த பெயிண்டிங்கை பார்த்துட்டு இருக்கிறது மட்டும் விஷயம் இல்லை அந்த பெயிண்டிங்கை பார்த்துட்டு என்ன மாதிரி ஃபீலிங் அவங்களுக்கு கிடைக்குது அதே மாதிரி தான் மூவிஸ்க்கும் ரைட் இப்போ சே ஐ டோன்ட் நோ சம்படி கிவ் மீ அன் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஆஃப் எனி மூவி வெயிட்டிங் எனிபடி கமா கைஸ் கிவ் மீ ஒன் மூவி எக்ஸாம்பிள்
Which language you want to
differ? Pick any. Okay. Yeah, any. Just pick
Avengers.
Any. Cool. Avengers. So when, if you think about that movie, immediately what feeling do you feel? You feel motivated. You feel like, oh, powerful, Thor, right? Everybody, it's like summer, right? That's the feeling that the storyteller or the writer would have wanted the viewers to feel. And that's what's important, right? And that's very important, not just important, but like really important. If you nail that down, I consider the feeling and the genre of your storytelling to be one of the most important pillars of your story, right? Pillar na, by what I mean by pillar is, now take your institution, right? SRM would probably have discipline as your pillar. அவங்க இனி வாட் எவர் ரூல்ஸ் வாட் எவர் சேஞ்சஸ் எனி திங் எனி நியூ டிசிப்ளின் தட் தே பிரிங் எனி நியூ யூனோ டீச்சர் ஆர் எனி படி தட் தே பிரிங் இன் இட் வில் நாட் மூவ் அவே ஃப்ரம் த ஃபேக்ட் தட் இட் ஹாஸ் குட் டிசிப்ளின் ரைட் நோ மேட்டர் வாட் தே டூ அதே மாதிரி தான் மூவிஸ்க்கும் இஃப் ஆர் ஸ்டோரிஸ் ரைட் எனி திங் ஃபார் தட் மேட்டர் இஃப் யூ ஹாவ் அ பில்லர் செட் நவ் ஐ எம் கோயிங் டு ஹாவ் மை அவெஞ்சர்ஸ் மூவி ஐ ஹாவ் அன் ஐடியா ரைட் ஸ்டான்லி இஸ் திங்கிங் ஐ எம் கோயிங் டு மேக் லெட்ஸ் மேக் திஸ் Avengers movie. And then he's going to be like, I want my viewers to feel the motivation and the thrill that all of my characters feel. So then every single scene, every single lighting, every single music, BGM, right, should have that power in it. And that's the same case for anything, any movie, even if it's romantic, then in that case, then the lighting will change, right? It'll become light and breezy. If it's thriller, it'll become different. Horror, same. Conjuring nalo andha mari dhaan vithyasam you can see, right? So that's a very, the feeling that as a storyteller, you want the viewers to feel is one of the most important pillars. Okay, I'll move on from this. This, I'm pretty sure you all must know. I won't go into too much detail of this, but this is a regular basic storyboard template that any storyboard artist should follow. I mean, can follow. It has like what your aspect ratio is, meaning 16:9 TV, in a theater, cinema, Elena, if you're going to do like some TikTok videos or something, your aspect ratio will change, and page number, blah, blah, what your scene is and what that shot is. Audio. Enna, I saw a bunch of your, your works, right? Storyboard work. And what I saw lacking was that scene neenga varinjirukinga, ana adu keela and the scene la enna nadakkudhu neenga ezhudala, right? It would be better if you do that. Meaning, and the scene la enna dialogue appo nadandhittu irukku. Ippo say like Avengers la, Thor is talking about, I am worthy of his hammer, right? So in that, if he's holding on to the hammer, the audio must say, Thor hyphen says, I am worthy, right? That's important. Because it's not just about what you draw. It's also about what is going on in the visuals. So this is a basic template that we'll all have to follow as a storyboard artist, right? So I'll move on. Cool. Yeah, I spoke a fair bit about it, so I won't go too much into it all over again. But yeah, the theme and the feeling, these are multiple, few of them. And there are like some 20, 50 other genre/themes that are there for movies that you can. Google is your best friend for this, right? So you can do that. You can look up on it. Adventure, romantic, thriller, action, horror, and so on. And the feeling that you want your viewers to feel from that is, if it's adventure, you must feel adventurous while you're watching it. Abdina, when you're watching Indiana Jones, right? He's just moving across. So that means your entire panning will be all about enga poyittu irukkaru, right? What is the area? So where is he, I don't know, adventuring, right? Sorry, that's a wrong word, but you get what I mean, right? And if it's romantic, so then it has to feel intimate and light. I mean, there must be some drama between two different people. So by intimate, I mean your shot becomes closer. It's between two people then, right? So such things you can keep in mind when you're talking about theme or feeling. Idhu edhukku important na, when you're thinking about what is my movie about, right? What is my story about? Neenga aarambikkumbodhu, this is something that you have to decide from the beginning itself, right? And if it's an action or a thriller movie, you want your viewer to be sitting at the edge of their seat and be watching that while they're watching. And it, horror, no? It has to scare them. Not necessarily, yeah, but yeah. Cool. Yeah, this is largely what I was talking about. As a game designer also, it's not just in movies, when I was working with games. So in movies, it's more of a screen that you sit and look at. But in games, the cool thing about it is that you get to have your player go inside your world. That's a pretty cool feeling. And that's a huge responsibility as well. Right? So because of that, I get to make sure that they feel exactly what I want them to feel. If I'm going to make a thriller game or a horror game, I can actually make them feel scared because of the interactions and the decisions that they make through the game, right? That's pretty much the theme/genre that I'm talking about. Sorry, feeling that I'm talking about. Right. And of course, there are chances as a artist or a designer that it's not possible at all for everybody to get your viewers to feel that 100% feeling, right? But you need to start somewhere and you need to have your pillars set. Okay, let's talk about characters. I'm going to go step by step, right? Now I've talked about the theme. Now I'm going to talk about characters. Just stay with me. What's going to happen is we'll talk about the characters, then we'll talk about backgrounds, composition, and we'll put it all together and we'll see how it all forms in a storyboard. Okay? Somebody say okay.
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
Thank you. Okay. Okay. So character development is a very important aspect in the industry, right? நீங்க நினைக்கலாம் நமக்கு ஸ்டோரி தான் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட், நம்மளோட தீம், நம்மளோட ஜான்ரு, அதெல்லாம் தான் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட். அவெஞ்சர்ஸ்ல நம்மளோட தார் அண்ட் யூனோ ப்ரூஸ் அண்ட் ஹூஎவர், யூனோ, இஃப் தோஸ் கேரக்டர்ஸ் ஆர் நாட் தேர், இஃப் தே டென்ட் ஹாவ் ஆல் ஆஃப் தட் டெப்த், த மூவி வுடன்ட் ஒர்க். Chumma, you can't just put one Black Widow there. Who is Black Widow? What is her backstory? Why is she there? What does she look like? All of those things play a ginormous role in the entire flow of the story, right? So that pretty much is why character development is important. So we cannot skip on that when it comes to storyboarding as well, right? Because you are the creator of a world. Think of yourself as a creator of an entire universe, right? It's not just one other movie that you're making or one other story. It is your story and that is your world. So அந்த உலகத்துக்குள்ள யாரெல்லாம் இருக்கிறாங்க, எதுக்காக அங்க இருக்கிறாங்க, எப்படி பார்க்க எப்படி இருப்பாங்க, இந்த ஒரு கேரக்டருக்கும் இந்த ஒரு கேரக்டருக்கும் ரிலேஷன்ஷிப் என்ன என்ன மீனிங் ஃபைட்டா இல்ல அது என் குட் ரிலேஷன்ஷிப் அது என் பேட் ரிலேஷன்ஷிப் ஹவு டஸ் தட் அஃபெக்ட் த வேர்ல்ட் ஆல் ஆஃப் தோஸ் திங்ஸ் இஸ் சம்திங் தட் யூ வில் ஹாவ் டு ஃபிகர் அவுட் ரைட் வென் யூ அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் யுவர் கேரக்டர் தென் யுவர் story will also get understood clearly by the viewer, right? When you give helps to give limitation to your character's personality. By that, I mean, say there's you see the toys over there, right? If I were God, right? And I'm creating zebra. Oh, okay. I am creating a zebra right now, right? It helps to have a limitation that the zebra will walk on four legs. Right. And it also helps to have a limitation that the zebra will have one tail. And the Mari, if you make a definition, have those limitations, that means the zebra will have four legs. Abdina anjam the kala anga varada. Correct. Aprom nadakum bodhu naal kala dhaan nadakum. So they can't eat anything like human beings. Those are all like limitations that will help in developing your character and your story later. Am I clear so far? I've been talking just like a radio.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. Cool. So as and when you keep developing your character, it doesn't mean that you will have to stop somewhere. But then if you keep working on your character little by little, it'll add more depth for your character and eventually for your story as well, right? If you just take like Black Widow, for example, right? If from the movie Avengers, in that the character has a backstory that she was trained and she had a very terrible childhood and whatever, all of those things. So that kind of added on to the character's depth. Abdina, avangaloda dialogue, adukaprama, every single interaction that she has with others will be very rough, will be very rude because she had a very not rude, I wouldn't say rude, but yeah, you get what I mean, right? Because she had a tough life in general. So that's the kind of depth that you can add to your character. But that doesn't mean just because you have to add restrictions to your characters does not mean that you can't go wild with your character. And I'm talking about, you can take the Hulk, for example, right? So most definitely, I think Stan Lee went a little, no, not a little, but he got a little crazy with the character, the Hulk, right? And that's like one of the most brilliant character design there. So yeah, that's what I mean. But I'm going to take Mr. Bugs Bunny as a simple example because I'm hoping everybody knows Bugs Bunny. I'm not going to show the video. I'm guessing everybody knows okay, I'll show it. It's fine.
It's wabbit season. Oh boy, wabbit, you're not out six wabbit. No, I've got you. What's up, Dad? I'm hunting wabbits. It's wabbit season. Would you like to shoot me, Nucky? Shoot him now. Split him.
Gotcha. So you think you can beat him?
Okay, you get the idea who the character I'm talking about, right? Okay, let's move on.
You got yourself.
Let's just look at a very simple character sheet, right? Even in games also, can you name any game? Anybody other than Irfan, please? Any game?
Prince of Persia.
Outlander.
What?
Outlast.
Outcast.
Outlast, pick, Outlast.
Outlast. I'll pick Prince of Persia.
Prince of Persia.
Okay. So in that game, it's a very cool game, but then there is a main character, right? So that character, regardless, will have to have some kind of backstory, will have to have some kind of a full-on, you know, get-up. Why does he have all of those things on him? He is a prince and blah, blah, all of those things. So you get what I mean, right? He needs to, any character, being movie or games, will have to have some kind of a character sheet to them, right? So if I were to go off of that and let's use that, put together a character sheet for Bugs Bunny, a very simple one, right? He is a gray and a white rabbit, right? And he has a signature character in hand. So that means wherever you see him in scenes in cartoons, he'll often be having a carrot in his hand. And that's his signature. Even Vijay, his signature is to wear a t-shirt and a shirt on top, right? So you can define that person from others. So that's a signature. And it'll be very cool to add a signature for each of your character. Yeah. And he's not very respectful. He's super casual with everything. He has a Brooklyn accent. So that means he's probably from New York, right? And he has a catchphrase and what's up, Doc, right? So those are all very cool, significant things that you can differentiate from this rabbit to other rabbits around the world in cartoons. And he's a trickster. He's very clever. He plays pranks on all the hunter and Daffy Duck and whatever, right? But that doesn't mean that was the in the rabbit dhaan first avanga aarambichil irundhi ippa varaikku in the rabbit dhaan illa, right? I mean, in the design dhaan irundhadhu illa. In the beginning, it used to look like this, right? Over time, as an artist or as a designer, you get to develop your character. Ippo, I drew this Bugs Bunny, but that doesn't mean that he will be fine. The artist clearly has added a carrot to his hand to add more signature style to him. And he has developed over time with adding chubby cheeks. So it can, the children around the world who are watching cartoons, who, when we used to watch this cartoon, it used to be more fun and more cuddlier to look at, right? More friendlier, yeah. So those things all you keep on adding. That's the good thing about character development, is that you can keep adding to your character over time. And these are some of my favorite, some that I could look up on, very well developed character examples. If you get access to this presentation, I would suggest you to go through all of these things, right? Some of the best character designs, I would suggest to look up Pixar Studios and of course Disney as well. Killer character design they have, right? And of course, when you are making your own characters, at some point you can use this particular slide, maybe if you can take a screenshot or something, to make your own character sheet and see how you can go with it. And maybe if I can request, I would like it if you can use this and make your own characters, and if you can send it to me, I would love to look at it, right? And I have two little videos that you can look at to understand character development a bit more. Okay, shall I move forward? Is it clear so far? You can ask me any questions about characters. Yes, anything? No?
No doubts, ma'am.
Okay, no doubts. Great. Okay, I'll move on. Okay, now I just want to talk about the importance of backgrounds, right? By backgrounds, I mean, am I still, one second, so sorry. Okay, good. Sorry. Okay, the importance of backgrounds, I mean that even when I was now I work as a game designer and art director or whatever, but earlier in my days of being an artist, right, I used to do paintings and whatnot. It was easier for me to just only draw the subject. And that's the case even when you're doing storyboarding, right? You will just draw whatever is necessary. Now say the man is going into the kitchen to get a cup of tea. So what you'll do is you'll just draw out your little man, and then you'll show him walking. But if you add the scene, that would add more depth to your story, right? And that's pretty important. And I'd like to talk to you about that so you won't make the same mistake. Think of backgrounds and characters like when you go to a concert, or a solo artist, like solo or party to come. Ilana, there's a solo guitarist. It would be very nice to listen to them doing their own thing solo. But then again, imagine every instrument and the singer, the guitarist, drummer, everybody coming together and making a composition. That's exactly what your scene should do with backgrounds and characters and lighting. And of course, camera angle, right? And that's how important, that's why it's important. They support one another instead of thinking of backgrounds as a intensive work, right? So we're just going to have a quick exercise kind of a thing. I need somebody to speak. What do you see when you look at this one little picture? Wait, I'll pick somebody because you all are not responding. A Chinese woman with an umbrella. What do you think the story is behind this? Meaning, avanga enna pannit irukanga, enga irukanga, edukaga anga irukranga?
Somewhere in China and she's walking somewhere.
Shopping.
She's going shopping. Okay. Can you tell me the time period or like meaning, right? What kind of a time period is she in?
Maybe in 12 or morning.
And the time period, right? In the century, like
80s.
In the 80s. Okay, fair enough. Okay, I'm going to. Now, can you tell me the story behind this? Like, when you look at this picture, what does it tell you? Anybody? Or the same person?
Or mother leaving her daughter to school.
Okay, that's okay. That's great. So you see the difference in the storytelling that you see when you add a scene to it along with your character, right? And that's why it's important. And it's not, you don't just see this only in the screen or in your photographs. This is pretty much what you have to sketch out when you're making storyboards. If you want your movie director to understand your story through storyboards, you have to be able to sketch out the scene as well. Only then will your story come through. Ennoda kada idu valiya solla porathu inda oru Chinese lady, she's dressed in full costume and she's walking down the street. And you can't do that with just doing this. Right, you will have to draw your street. You will have to show at what time and the time vandu eludhana podada. The lighting vecha, unga shadows vecha, ipo idhula shadows kammiya irukku. So that means it's probably around 12 o'clock in the afternoon. Do you get what I mean? Right, and there's this little school girl. So it's probably around maybe not 12. It could be past 3. Maybe she's going home after school. And the little girl is also wearing rain boots. Right, so that means it's probably going to rain. So those are all chinna chinna details that could add on to your story, right? Same. I'd like to do the same exercise now. Can you tell me the story behind this? Anybody?
A woman walking her dog.
Taking her dog out for poop.
Nice. Good. That is a poop bag. So yes, I approve. Okay. Now, can you tell me the story behind this with the background and everything? What's going on?
She's scooping her dog.
And the lady is taking her dog for a walk.
And?
And you can see that man there. He's just seeing the lady, and immediately we can create a romance scene like that.
Okay. We need to come home.
Ma'am.
Those two girls must be our friends, I think.
Okay.
The lady is laughing at the camera because her dog is lying down on the street.
Exactly. Sorry? What? Did somebody say something?
I want to tell ma'am, it's not willing to come home.
Ah, yeah, correct, exactly, right? So the difference that I see between these two photographs or slides is that there is a lady just sitting with the dog is just sitting there. But now the whole story changes that the dog is not willing to go home and has settled on the road, right? So that's the whole, there's a fair bit of storytelling that you can see over there. And it seems like it's a very busy day. So she wants to get home because she needs to move on with her life. But the dog is like, no, this is your life now. So that's the cool thing about adding your entire composition, which adds on to your storytelling, right? Okay. I have a few videos that I want to show, but I don't know if you have the time. So you know what I'll do? I'll go through the rest of the slides. We'll see if we have some time. And if we do, we'll come back and watch this, right? Okay. We should just start sketching. Is it possible to for you all to sketch?
Yes.
Okay, great.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So then pull out your sketchbooks and pencils and we'll do something. We'll just talk about storyboard, the scene right now, and we'll storyboard quickly. Cool. Let's say the scene is that our actor Vijay faces off with a villain in a fight scene. Now we talked about the importance of character, and we also talked about the importance of backgrounds and which will eventually come together as a good composition to tell you about the story and the scene, right? Now you have to, and we also talked about the importance of visualizing each and every single word in your story. Now, this is a summary. This is a scene of a summary. This is a summary of a scene. Vijay faces off with a villain in a fight scene. And you being the designer and you being the person who creates your entire movie and the story, what do you, you can make the decision, what time, where, who's the villain, what do they look like, and all of those things, right? I'll just tell you what my decisions are so you'll get an idea of this, right? So the things that you will have to keep in mind when you're thinking, when you're visualizing this particular scene. Vijay faces off with a villain in a fight scene. Your camera angle, right? By camera angle, I mean Vijay is the hero and there is a villain. So epome, it's always nice to do things like, say these are two people. These are your two characters, right? இது உங்களோட ஹீரோ, இது உங்களோட வில்லன். உங்க ஹீரோ யாருன்னு காட்டுறதுக்கு உங்க சீன்ல எப்பவுமே இந்த ஆளு ஓட ஷார்ட் பெருசா இருந்தா நல்லா இருக்கும். வெயிட், ஐல் ஷோ யூ. சே இமேஜின் திஸ் இஸ் யுவர் ஷார்ட், ரைட்? அண்ட் தென் இட்ஸ் ஆல்வேஸ் நைஸ் டு ஷோ யுவர் ஹீரோ அஸ் லுக்கிங் லைக் கோலியாத். ஓகே, கோலியாத் இஸ் லைக் அ லார்ஜ் ஜாயண்ட், அண்ட் ரைட், அண்ட் யுவர் வில்லன் நீட்ஸ் டு லுக் லிட்டில் ஸ்மாலர் ஸோ தட் யுவர் hero looks like he can defeat, right? That's your camera angle. Elements like prefix and suffix matters. By that I mean in the villain hero engendu varanga odi po engendo chase scene kaprama varangla, that is your prefix. Appra vandit enga nikkranga, that's your middle part. What will happen after that, that is your suffix, right? And what time is it, right? All of those things. Now imagine you are just saying there is a person standing facing the hero. That's it. அப்படியே நீங்க சொன்னீங்கன்னா, the only thing that you will draw is two people standing next to each other. And if you say a hero is facing his opponent, that means the hero's shot will immediately grow, correct? And at the same time, now if you're going to say a hero is facing his opponent at 12 o'clock in the afternoon, அப்படினா you will have to show light. You will have to show where the sun is, like correct mele irukku. So your shadows and your lighting and your, you know, all of those things can clearly be seen and it will be very beautiful for your scene, right? A hero faces his opponent at 12 o'clock in the afternoon, catching his breath after running. That means they both will be standing there like this and then like breathing heavily and then they'll be standing there. So these little things, if you show in your storyboard, it'll add a lot of storytelling to your entire scene. And the last one, let's say there are also some onlookers, meaning even the rendu perum, they are having a face off, your hero and your villain are standing there, Apod, you are adding onlookers to it. So that means your scene immediately becomes more dramatic, more intense, right? Because now there are like people around. Enna pannuvaanga? There are also people standing there. Do they have some kind of, influence on this fight? What is going on? All of those things you can add on to it, right? Do you get what I mean? Do you guys have any questions? Please ask. I assigned someone to say okay, no? Who is that?
Yeah, okay, ma'am.
Got it, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, good. Cool. You know what? Let's just start sketching. Okay. You remember the scene, right? What I just explained right now. Can we do a quick sketch? Also, I'd like to do another screen share. Is that okay? Is that possible?
Yes, ma'am, you can.
Let me try. All of you are just like, if you can get your sketchbooks out, that would be great. And put together one scene. Just make one scene with hero facing a villain. That's it. Just draw that. Can we do that? Say okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm going to wait for a bit. Let's say now the time is around 2:57. So we'll just get something and finish it by 3. Hmm? I mean, 3 minutes, no? 3:05. Hmm?
Okay, ma'am. I've done mine, ma'am.
Sorry?
I've done, ma'am.
Yeah, can I see? Can you, like, I don't know, open your, turn on your camera and just, like, show it on screen or something? It's okay. Or like just take a picture and send it on chat. That's also more comfortable. Nice. Okay. It's happening at night, is it? Is that why there's a lamppost? Or would you like to talk about it?
Yes, ma'am, it's a lamppost and it's raining there.
Huh.
They are ready for face off.
Oh, great, great. Okay, good. Good enough. I like it. Nice work. Anybody else? We'll just do one more person and then we'll move on. Or like two more people. Anybody? Hey, Irfan, why didn't you pick someone?
Yeah, ma'am. Shakti is ready to show. Right?
Please show Shakti. Whenever you're ready. It's just
Hello,
3-3.
Ma'am?
Yeah.
I'll show my thing.
Please do. Shakti Vail, right? I don't think I can see you.
Just a minute.
Okay, fine.
This is it is like the hero being cornered on a broken bridge, and it is nearly 12.
Nice. Great. You've added a lot of story to it. There's a bit of background to it. Yeah, you're getting the idea. And you've added like more than one villain also. So that's good. Yeah, that's good on you. One more person and we'll be done. Okay, I won't ask anyone else. Okay, Shakti Vail, can you pick someone to share?
Yeah, just a minute. I'll check. Ma'am?
Yeah? Oh, great. I can't see JC, etc. And Kabilan. Can you talk about it a little, please? Oh, I can't see.
I'm Katala, ma'am.
Or a factory site, ma'am.
Ire, yaar ipo pesuradhu? I thought Kabilan's camera is on. Who is showing now?
Some Kabilan is showing.
Okay. ஓகே கொஞ்சம் அதை பத்தி கொஞ்சம் பேச முடியுமா?
ஹலோ கேக்குதா? ஹலோ மேம் கேக்குதா?
ஆ இட் இஸ்
கம்ப்ளைன்ட். தட்ஸ் a lot of disturbance behind. தட்ஸ் a lot of disturbance behind.
I think Sivaranjani wanted to.
Ma'am.
Yeah. Yes, ma'am. Can I?
Yeah. Can you share something, Sivaranjani? Kavilan, can you figure out your situation? By then, I'll just look at Sivaranjani.
Adha, ma'am. Hero vandu shoot pandraru andha shot mari.
Hero shoot pandraru. I like your difference in sizes, Kavilan, with your characters. சிவரஞ்சனி உங்களுக்கும் கொஞ்சம் காட்ட முடியுமா?
ஆ எஸ் மேம் ஜஸ்ட் a minute. I don't think my camera's working. Oh, damn it. Can you see me?
I can see you.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, good.
Can you see the...
Yes.
Drawing?
Okay. Yes.
Yeah, there's some rain and they're fighting in a market and can you see the goons there? The main villain and he's defeated all the goons.
Okay.
And yeah, that's it. It's raining and he has knives and all. Yeah,
that's great. Oh, good, good. So you've added props and you've added some amount of extra characters and you've you've also added a situation, meaning a space where they are, which is a mark. That's great. Nice work. Amit Abdul, if you would like to share now?
Ma'am, can we move on to the next session? They'll show it in the end of the session.
No problem. Okay. FA gamers. I mean, your hand is up, so I'm guessing you wanted to share something? Or no? FA gamers. I don't know what his name is. Is Sambarish. Of course, come, sure. S. Ambarish. Am I saying it right?
Mama, can I show my art?
Yes, please. Go on.
Just a minute, ma'am. The video is not showing, ma'am. I think you're not able to unmute on my video, ma'am.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Yeah, good.
This is my art, ma'am. I also named the villains actually in this. It's a little bit blurry. I'll explain the scene, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, the hero is sleeping in the house, ma'am. And due to some, in the afternoon, 2 o'clock, the villains come around and the villain here, I have named the villain also. It's one of my favorite villains, Sayaji Shinde. And he asked, I even wrote the dialogues, ma'am, for this. He's asking his goons to get him out. And Tamil avanga solranga veliya vaada appadina oru slang la solranga, ma'am, his goons. They are armed with weapons, knives, guns, etc. The hero is coolly sleeping in his bedroom and the goons go to his house and try to drag him out, but hero kicks them all like that, ma'am. Then the fight starts. That's all, ma'am.
Nice. I like how you've thought through from like even before the fight begins. And then I like how you've like thought through a bunch of these different scenarios for that one scene. That's really good.
Thank you.
I think Amit Abdul raised their hand again, so I'm guessing they want to share. Yes.
Ma'am? Excuse me, ma'am. Can we move on to the next thing, because it's, I think it's already time for them. Let's let them show their sketches at the end of the session.
Fair enough.
Okay.
No problem. Let's go. Before that, I did want to share how you can possibly also sketch out certain things. Right? My example of what you can do for this. Hang on. Can you see?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. So let's just get into it, right? We were talking about one hero and a villain having a face-off, right? So let's say that this is your scenario, right? And there is a space over here. So there's a bit of perspective going on. You're going to show a little bit of depth, right? And here is your villain right here, right? I have made a decision that I want to show the villain to be really small, because for me, my hero is important, right? So in that case, I would show a bit of the hero like that. And then have him little hunched. You know, shoulders down, because I am also making the decision that they just came back after a run. So adhanala dust konjam angenge irukra madri I'm going to show, right? This is a good way to do your storyboarding. If you're not really good at like super, you don't have to be an extreme perfect expert in art, right? You don't have to be a great artist in order to be a storyboard artist. You can do whatever with whatever you can. So I can just draw like a little bit of dots over here and point out saying it's going to be dust, right? So this is going to be my perspective. From the, you're looking at the villain over your hero's shoulder, right? So that's what's happening. And I'm also adding a little bit of scenario over here. This is going to be like some rundown place, maybe like a, say like a Binny Mills kind of a situation, you know, padathil ella irukume andha mari area la. And then I'm going to show, add a bit of depth by adding a bunch of buildings over here to show you are in this city area. Adhe time la, I'm going to show it's also happening in Chennai. So I'm going to add like some palm trees in the background, and it's going to be 12 o'clock in the afternoon. So my lighting is going to come from this direction. When I say lighting, I don't just mean like what lighting, what time is it? I'm also talking about which direction is your lighting coming from, right? So that would mean your shadows are going to be here. And inga inda light varudna, you have to show that your shadows are going to be here, right? So that's one of the few things that your character, your storyboarding has to have. This is one way of doing that. Another way I could do is same thing. I'm going to say my villain is going to be standing here, right? And he's very small. And I'm going to show my hero to be a giant, madri, shorter. But I'm going to show the villain standing close by. Feet angle. So now in this is another manner that you can show, and I still can show that the hero is the main character and the villain is a small character, and eventually the hero is going to beat the villain up, right? So these are different ways that you can do. Again, now say inger in the lighting, in the direction lighting, na naan solrana, ungalaoda storyboard, these are all like little technical things that you have to add eventually, right? So then your shadow will come over here. Mm-hmm. And the Mari things and all you can add. Right? So that's the idea that you can do. And one other thing that I would request all of you to start doing is start adding your dialogues. இப்போ உங்க ஸ்கிரிப்டில் இருக்கிற மாதிரி அவ்வளோ பெரிய டைலாக்ஸ், சில படத்துல விஜய் வந்துட்டு ஒரு பேராகிராஃப் சொல்வாரு, அந்த பேராகிராஃப் ஃபுல்லா சொல்லணும்னு தேவையில்லை, அங்கே எழுதி வைக்கணும்னு தேவையில்லை. அந்த அந்த சிச்சுவேஷன்ல இருக்கிற ஐடியா என்ன, மீனிங் அந்த ஃபீலிங் உங்களுக்கு, வாட் ஷுட் யுவர் வியூவர் ஃபீல், ரைட்? இஸ் கோயிங் டு டாக் அபவுட் சம் ஐ எம் கோயிங் டு பீட் யூ அப் அண்ட் யூ வில் டை, ரைட்? இஸ் வாட் யுவர் ஹீரோ இஸ் சேயிங், அப்படின்னு யூ ஷுட் ஸ்டார்ட் ரைட்டிங் ஓவர் ஹியர், ரைட்? ஸோ தட் பிகாஸ் ஆடியோ வென் கம்ஸ் டு மூவிங் பிக்சர்ஸ், ரைட், இட்ஸ் நாட் ஜஸ்ட் அபவுட் த photographs and the cinema alone. It's also about the audio, the sound, music, the BGM, the lighting and everything. Like I said, it's a composition. Everything comes together. So your audio is very, just as equally important. So if you write down the dialogue, neenga inga vandittu na heroica you can write, or if you write comedic, then your entire scene changes, right? So that's why audio is kind of important here as well, right? Okay. I'll stop screen sharing. And I'll screen share my presentation now. Yeah. Okay, good. This was a good exercise. I really enjoyed that. I do want to see all of your storyboards, whatever you've done. So Ambarish, maybe after the talk, if that's okay. Very sorry. Okay. Let's move on. Cool. So certain things that it would be nice for a storyboard artist or even a storyteller to keep in mind while you're putting together your visual thoughts, right, is to have a mood board for reference, right? If it's difficult, so these are all little points that you need to keep in mind in order to train your mind to visualize everything. So at a time like you are thinking there are going to be two characters now, what will happen is this will become flat. One character inga irukku, innoru character inga irukku. Ana, but if you start training your mind to visualize better, you can have, then I think your visualization and your storyboarding will change drastically. Appo, I'm thinking there is a hero. So then my hero is like a big character, right? Not a big character, but you get what I mean, right? Your angle changes. Your view changes into the whole scene. So your contrast and scale for between two different characters, and even if it's like five different characters, your contrast and scale, even Godzilla, right? You see the drastic difference between those two. So those are all things that even visual designers could get into. That's the kind of space that you all need to start developing and getting into. And I know certain things like camera angles and panning is all something only the camera artists need to think about, but that's not the case at all. Camera angles is like super important for storyboard artists, right? Because that's where your scene development starts, not just for camera artists, cameramen or women. So things like making use of panning, where all can I use panning? You can start thinking about, okay, let me just put together one scene and then see where all I can try and put panning inside that, right? You can start with little exercises like that. And then eventually you will get to a point where you will know when to use and when not to use good panning, right? With your framing. And staging and framing, meaning long shot. I'm guessing you know what that means. Long shot, na New York City, kalli irukkara maari, that's a long shot. Truck shot is like I'll show you a video about it, right? So then you'll get the idea. You get a tilt, right? So if you're moving if we are moving our head from down to above, that's pretty much what the camera will also move like. That's what tilt is, right? Close-ups, down shot is மேல இருந்து கீழே பாக்குற மாதிரி, நம்ம இப்ப பார்த்தோமே ஷோல்டர்ல இருந்து கீழே அந்த கேரக்டர் பாக்குற மாதிரி. ஸ்விஷ் இஸ் மோர் லைக் வென் கேப்டன் அமெரிக்கா இஸ் ரன்னிங் ஃப்ரம் லெஃப்ட் டு ரைட் ஆஃப் தி யுவர் ஸ்கிரீன். ஸோ பேக்ரவுண்ட் ஃபுல்லா மூவ் ஆகுது, பட் யுவர் கேமரா இஸ் ஃபோக்கஸிங் ஆன் தட் ஒன் கேரக்டர். ஸோ தட் ஸ்விஷ், ரைட்? அண்ட் த பேனிங் இஸ் லைக் யூ மூவ் வித் அன் என்டயர் சீன். இங்க இருந்து இங்க வரைக்கும் மூவ் ஆகுது, ஸோ யூ ஆர் கவரிங் த ஹோல் சீன், தட் இஸ் பேனிங். பட் ஸ்விஷிங் இஸ் this is your main character. Your character is moving and your camera is moving along with it. So that's swishing. So these are all things that you can keep in mind while you're doing your storyboarding. And upshot is kirendu mele paakara madri, to show how big your character is or your that particular scene is, right? And certain things, more like if you are good at drawing, it would help for you to write down your story in bullet points instead of writing it in one big novel. But instead, if you put it down in little small points from point A to point B, how can you keep it as short as possible? Right now, if you remember our first scenario, that, you know, Akhil went into the kitchen to get a cup of tea for his headache. That was the shortest form of one entire scene. If you were going to write a story, and if I were to make it complex, it would be that a 40-year-old man who had a very difficult day and had a very difficult time in life and just got divorced and was starting to develop a headache and he didn't know what to do. And because his life was in shambles and his only solution is to go get a cup of tea to soothe himself. And he tried to do that. So he got up and he was in tears. And while he went into the kitchen, he opened the fridge to get a ginger, to cut the ginger and put it in his coffee. That's too complex. How do you shorten that? Put it in kutti bullet points and then figure it out, right? Find references. Google is, again, your best friend for everything. Now, I can look up anybody. Like, I can probably, if I want to find reference for what will a man look like, just go search things like man sketch, copy it, done, okay? And then just do that. And if you're going to do like a house scenario, right? House sketch, copy, that's it. Keep it simple with whatever you can do, do it. But more than what you draw, the how you draw it, meaning your capacity to visualize it is more important than you being able to draw a proper sketch perfectly, right? Your concept is more important than your final work. That you need to get. Yeah? Yes. Okay.
Okay.
And yeah, similarly, if you're not good at drawing, just write down your story in bullet points, find references, just start with simple stick figures. Again, I can't repeat this enough. Your concept, your scene, and your camera angle, and your technical things like lighting and audio is way more important than the actual thing itself. If you get that, if you get the actual drawing, well and good. But if you get the whole scene with like the dramatic effect or the thrilling effect or the sorrowful effect and the lighting and everything, that's magical, right? And again, there's another easy way to do it. Just trace it. If you're not that great at drawing, try and trace something out. You just need to get your scene right before. Cool. I was hoping we could do another exercise. Do we have time for it? I wanted to do another sketch exercise with everyone. Is it possible? Yes, no? Irfan, right? Or somebody else?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Can we do another exercise with everyone? I wanted to do another.
Once I'll confirm with my sir and we'll get you.
Raisa? Yeah. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah. Then I can assign the work among the students and then send it over the works to you personally so that you can answer it and then feedback. Is it fine?
That will also be great. Yeah. I would love it if the students can have their own time, do their own research and figure it out and draw. Yeah. I would love that.
Yeah. Fine.
Okay. So this is the scene. I'll talk about it a little. So you'll have some, just like maybe take notes for the exercise later. The scene is this, right? There is a 5-year-old boy who wakes up in the morning, goes to his kitchen to have breakfast. The genre can be anything. By that I mean, in the kutti payan kaalaiyil endrichu poi saapida poran and the time la edho comedy nadakkudhu is what you can decide as a story writer. Adhe time la idha horror ah kuda maathalam. அவன் காலையில எந்திரிச்சு போய் சாப்பிட போறான். ஆனா பார்த்தா அவனோட ஃபுல் ஃபேமிலி மர்டர், they've been murdered, right? That is horror. And it can also be thriller. ஒரு குட்டி பையன் காலையில எந்திரிச்சு போய் சாப்பிட போறான், ஆனா பார்த்தா அது அவன் வீடு கிடையாது, எங்க இருக்கானே தெரியல, ரைட்? அதுவே காமெடி. காலையில எந்திரிச்சு போறான், தடுக்கி தடுக்கி விழுறான், கீழே விழுறான், எல்லாம் பண்றான். ஒரு நாய் வந்து அவன் மேல என்ன குதிக்குது. All of those things. You get what I mean, right? The genre can be anything. Pick whatever you want. But the storyline remains. Your ending and your middle, what all of the, your, the jazz, you can change. The frames need to be four or less. Keep it as simple as possible. And try and fit in everything. The things that you have to add is description. First frame, Kira. 5-year-old boy, bed. And ஒரு குட்டி பையன் இருக்கு. So you'll have to write your description. You have to write your lighting description. எங்க இருந்து லைட் வருது, லேம்ப் இருக்கா, பெட் பக்கத்துல லேம்ப் இருக்கு, சரி. அப்புறம் அவன் எந்திரிச்சு போறான், ஹால்வேக்கு போறான், மீனிங் வீட்டுல இருந்து வெளியில, சாரி, ரூம் விட்டு வெளியில இறங்கும் போது லைட்டே இல்லை, டார்க்கா இருக்கு. அதெல்லாம் யூ ஹாவ் டு ரைட். காலையில எந்திரிச்சு பார்க்கும்போது விண்டோல இருந்து லைட்டே வரல, ஆனா ஹி தாட் இட் வாஸ் மார்னிங். ஆல் ஆஃப் தோஸ் திங்ஸ், யூ கெட் வாட் ஐ மீன். கேமரா டிஸ்கிரிப்ஷன் ஆல்சோ இஸ் லைக் சூப்பர் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட். Right, and if there is any audio, meaning any dialogues to it, you will have to add that as well. This is the overall brief, I would say, for the exercise. Keep this in mind. Cool? Is that okay? Good, good. Yes, no? Somebody say okay.
Yes, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
Thank you.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, actually, students want to interact with you right now. They have a few questions that they want to ask. So can we move on to the interactive session now?
Yeah, actually done. I'm on my last slide. So
okay, ma'am. Okay. Just finish off this and we can move on to the interactive session.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Thank you.
No problem. Again, these are some of the best storyboard artists are also comic artists, and I love drawing comics. I draw comics all the time for my team and for my company. These are some of the best books that I'd suggest you to buy. Or even if it's on Kindle, please go ahead and read it. Just look at each frames and just look at each different kind of angles that they use. One of the things that I would suggest is maybe copy them and try them out for yourself so you can study them, and then try making your own story and start developing on that. But these are all some really good books that I would suggest you to read. Yeah, great.
Okay, guys, we are moving on to the question answer session. So if you have any questions, you can unmute yourself and ask. Okay, but then ask one by one. Okay.
Go ahead, whoever wants to ask anything.
இன்னொருத்தங்களுக்கு தெரிவிக்கணும்னா
உங்களுக்கு வரையறது ரொம்ப முக்கியம்னா வரைஞ்சுதான் காட்டணும்னு உங்களுக்கு அவ்வளோ இம்பார்ட்டன்ட்னா it would be nice if you can try some basic courses for drawing, right? அதுவே இல்ல வரைய என்னால சுத்தமா முடியல, நான் படிச்சு கூட பார்த்தேன். Without trying, I don't know. So I would suggest try learning to draw some basics at least. அது இல்ல அது பண்ணிட்டும் you are not able to do anything, then I would suggest just go for like stick figure drawings, right? Just like put together a man is eating an ice cream. Draw a stick figure and then draw an ice cream, right? It's all about the emotion. So stick figure na chumma in the circle kuchi adu mattum illa adula oru face irukku and the face la evlo emotion irukku neenga kaatninga na unga concept eppadi vandrum. I have survived with stick figures for a long time because game design la ippo idea sonna adutha nimisham you have to show the concepts, right? Because it's all about like time and movement. And when I was at Baiju's, it was, or like Disney, fast pasta, oru 1 week le we'll have to finish one entire episode or like one entire chapter of like game, right? So for that, it has to be, it has to move very fast. So adukaga stick figure vechittu I have survived a lot. But it's all about the emotion. Verum kuchi varinjittu prachana illa, you'll have to get your emotions right. As long as you get your feeling through, you'll be golden.
Thank you, ma'am. But another doubt is like more than drawing, more than nama vandu oru vishayatha solrom, like adu vandu eppadi nama vandu adutha solravanga kitta eppadi nama impress pandrathu, like how to impress the other person who I'm explaining to. Ipo na my drawing okay oru similar ah irukku, but avarku oru alavukku puriyudhu enoda perspective avlava puriyala appadina na eppadi vandu how to communicate and impress.
அதுக்கு டைம் எடுக்கும். அப்புறம் நீங்க எல்லாரையும் இம்ப்ரெஸ் பண்ண முடியாது, கண்டிப்பா முடியாது. பிகாஸ் உங்களோட ஐடியாஸ், உங்களோட மைண்ட், உங்களோட தாட் ப்ராசஸ் இன்னொருத்தங்களுக்கு கிட்ட இருக்காது. இப்ப நான் காட்டுறது ஐ டோன்ட் நோ, மேபி இர்ஃபான் மைட் நாட் லைக், அதுக்காக ஐ கான்ட் டூ எனி திங், ரைட்? ஐ ஹாவ் டு கீப் ஒர்க்கிங், ஐ ஹாவ் டு கீப் டூயிங் வாட் ஐ வாண்ட், அண்ட் அஸ் லாங் அஸ் ஐ கேன் ஃபைண்ட் சம்படி ஹூ லைக்ஸ் மை ஒர்க், தட்ஸ் ஃபைன். ஸோ யூ கான்ட் இம்ப்ரெஸ் எவ்ரி ஒன். You have to understand that, and as long as you can accept it, you'll be good.
Thank you.
But I understand, as a student, you do want to impress people, but you do want to, you know, you have marks and you have to graduate and all of those things. Then in that case, I would suggest try and understand your assignment better. எதுக்காக அது கேட்டிருக்காங்க, என்னத்துக்காக அந்த assignment இருக்கு. What is the goal of that particular assignment? Try and talk to your teacher as much as possible. Silent ah illama pesitey irumbodhu you will get more information. Oh, avar adhu dhaan expect pandraru, you know, andha mari solittu neenga pesitey irundha, neenga communicate pannitey irundha, andha oru aala you can definitely, maybe, I mean 100% yaarku solla mudiyadhu, but yeah, you'll get there.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
No.
Yeah. Dishan from first year.
Yeah, hi.
You want to set our background first, or you want to set our character first? Because the character we are drawing is disturbing the background we have drawn already. What you suggest?
I think it depends on your story and on your scenario. If you have things set in your mind, if I'm going to think about, say, like, I don't know, give me an example. There is a girl going to school, walking to school. If that's my scene, and I've set that in my mind as a storyteller, appo immediately I have to see how can I fit it in, right? So then it's all about a girl walking to school, and you're showing that vari and the vari poet irukumbodhu neenga kaatringa. So you'll have to say, you know there's going to be a street, you know there's going to be some vehicles, you know there is a girl, right? So I guess according to the importance of it, you can show the difference between these two things. But again, it depends. I don't think there is any one way to say, like, neenga first character dhaan podano adukapram da background ponona, it will never work that way. It depends from one person to the other. So enakku personally, this is how I work. I usually understand my character, right? And then you saw me sketching, right? I put my floor down here and the area first I'll set it, and then I'll place my character over it. So that's how I generally work. It varies from one person to the other, one artist to the other. You'll have to keep working, and then you will figure out your own framing sense, I guess.
Aren't unable to confirm the characters we are designing now, because it may changes due to our imagination. So that,
yeah, totally.
It's disturbing the background we are drawing. So that,
yeah, it'll help with your perspective if you place your horizon line first. இப்போ என்னோட frame-ஐ நீங்க பாத்தீங்கன்னா உங்களுக்கு தெரியுது இங்க ஒரு line இருக்கு, so that means there's a sofa. And then there is a girl here, right? So if you set your line first, then I think that's how traditionally also we're taught to draw, like still life in the sela paintings ellam paathirupingala jar mug apuram apples ella irukum, நாங்க எப்பவுமே ஃபர்ஸ்ட் சொல்லி கொடுத்துருக்கிறது அந்த ஒரு ஹொரைசன் லைன் வரைஞ்சிட்டு அப்புறம் பிளேஸ்மெண்ட் எங்க இருக்கும்னு இட் வில் பி ஈஸியா ஃபார் யூ டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட். தட்ஸ் அ சிம்பிளர் வே டு எக்ஸ்பிளைன்.
மேம்
யா
ஆக்சுவலா உங்களோட ஏதாவது ப்ரீவியஸ் வொர்க்ஸ் காட்ட முடியுமா? நீங்க ஸ்டோரி போர்ட் பண்ணது
கிளீனா? நான் கம்பெனில ஸ்டோரி போர்ட் பண்ணது எல்லாமே இட்ஸ் ஆக்சுவலி அண்டர் வித் பைஜூஸ். Here at my place, I don't think I have any of them with me. I'm so sorry, I keep sometimes deleting them. But I'll find something out. How about this? I'll put them together and maybe I can send it to your professor. As and when you guys are sending your storyboards over, I'll send mine as well so you can look at it. Is that okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Say okay.
Okay, ma'am. Sure, ma'am.
உங்களால
சோ அதனால தான் இப்ப சென்னை எக்ஸ்பிரஸ் மூவில வில்ல வந்து ரொம்ப ஹைட்டா இருப்பான், ஷாருக் கான் வந்து குள்ளமா காட்டியிருப்பாங்க. எப்படின்னா வில்லனோட ஹெட் கிட்ட கேமரா வச்சு ஷாருக் கான் ரொம்ப குள்ளமா காட்டியிருப்பாங்க. சோ அது அதையும் பீப்புள் எடுத்துக்கிறாங்க. பட் ஆனா பாகுபலியில பிரபாசியும் ராணாவையும் அந்த நடுவுல நைஃப் அந்த போஸ்டர் இருக்கும்ல ஈக்குவலா வச்சாலும் பீப்புள் ஏத்துக்கிறாங்க. எப்படி அது எப்படி
அது ஏன் தெரியுமா? ஏன்னா நம்ம சென்னை எக்ஸ்பிரஸ்ல ஸ்டார்டிங்ல இருந்து எண்டு வரைக்கும் நம்ம ஹீரோவை ஒரு சாதாரண மனுஷனாதான் காட்டுறாங்க. அதாவது அந்த ஃபைட் சீன்ல கூட அவரு கீழே விழுந்து விழுந்து தடுமாறி தடுமாறி எந்திரிச்சு பிகாஸ் தேர் ஷோயிங் ஹிம் ஆஸ் அ வெரி நார்மல் பாவ மனுஷன். அதனால்தான் அந்த வில்லன பெரிய மனுஷனா காட்டுறா, பிகாஸ் ஹீஸ் லைக் சூப்பர் ஸ்ட்ராங் அண்ட் யூனோ ஹீஸ் கோயிங் டு பீட் த ஹீரோ அப். தட் டிஃபரன்ஸ் இஸ் தேர், ரைட்? புரியுதா? ஆனா பாகுபலியில என்னவா இருந்தாலும் பாகுபலி தான் பெரிய ஆளு. ஆனா இந்த மூவில அந்த இமோஷன் டிஃபரன்ஸ், அந்த கான்செப்டே டிஃப்ரெண்ட். இதுல ஹீரோ பேர் ஹீரோவா இருந்தாலும் கடைசி வரைக்கும் அவரு விழுந்து விழுந்து எப்படியோ சமாளிச்சுதான் அவரு ஹீரோ ஃபைட் ஜெயிக்கிறார். அதனாலதான் அப்படி காட்டியிருக்காங்க.
ஓகே, தேங்க் யூ மேம்.
3 more questions.
மேம், I have a question, மேம்.
Yes, please.
Ma'am, I've seen a lot of games, ma'am. In that, the graphics, some of the games, graphics are really awesome, ma'am. I want to know how they create this environment, this awesome environment of many games, ma'am. I just want to know that.
That's pretty much the technology, no? That has, that's the brilliantness of our science and technology.
Okay. But it seems really realistic, ma'am.
I know, right? Yeah, it's pretty cool, ma'am.
2020.
Even if you look at some of the cutscenes and all, your friend must be, sorry, your professor must be able to show you a bunch of those brilliant cutscenes. For he showed me when I was studying with him, he showed me Assassin's Creed cutscene and all, and we like tripped on it like anything. It was pretty cool. Yeah, it was very realistic. Even a bunch of like Witcher and everything, if you look at it, it's super realistic.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah. I recently saw Assassin's Creed Valhalla, ma'am. That's why I was asking about that.
Yeah, man, it's pretty cool. Yeah. But yeah, I mean, that's all up the greatness of technology and humans.
Do they have to work hard, work a long time and create these cutscenes, like days and years sometimes?
Sorry?
Ma'am, how much time do you have to take to create these cutscenes, ma'am? How much time do they take?
You can look it up, actually. It will take like for certain game. I don't know about cutscenes, but games take like years and years to make. We've been working on like 2D educational game and it's already been 2 years and we still don't have a finished product yet. So I can tell you it'll take a long time.
It's a long process, ma'am.
It's a huge process, yeah.
Just another question, ma'am. Just related to that. Ma'am, I happened to read some comics, ma'am, on DC. Their term comes to my mind, ma'am. Breaking the fourth wall. What does that mean, ma'am? Breaking the fourth wall.
That's a good question. So breaking the fourth wall means, you know, when you and so say there's a comic where or like
Dr. Fate, ma'am. Dr. Fate's Nabu's helmet goes over the universe and comes back in 0.2 seconds, like that, ma'am.
Over the universe and comes back in 0.2
seconds. At the end of the universe.
Okay.
That's the data they sell. They tend to break the fourth wall, ma'am. That's what they described.
So
Dr. Fate.
Yeah, I guess that kind of clears describes it clearly, no? No?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, why do they include this kind of scenes, ma'am? I don't understand.
What do you mean by that?
Why do they tend to include scenes that breaking the fourth wall, like that impossible scenes, something we can't even imagine?
Because somebody has to. Because if that person didn't do it, maybe tomorrow you will do it.
Okay.
It's all, I mean, there's no, you know, restriction to how well you can imagine and how much you can imagine and just.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, tends to go absurd, ma'am, sometimes. That's why.
Some of my favorite people are the ones that just break the rules. Meaning, I don't mean like, I'm not saying break the rules. Please don't do that. But I mean that, what I mean by that is when they just go like on the extreme level of absurdness with movies and storytelling and it gets approved and they get some kind of investment for it to get it done.
Yes,
this
ma'am.
Is brilliant. Yeah.
Well, that's all, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much.
Perfect. Did somebody else have something to say?
Hello.
Yeah, please. Amy Cruz.
Hello, ma'am. Is it audible?
Yes.
Ah, ma'am. இப்போ 2D வந்து peakல இருக்கு ma'am. இது அனிமே அதெல்லாம் peakல இருக்குல ma'am. 2D ஆ 3D ஆ எதுல ma'am இது பண்ணது? இப்போ எப்படி உங்களுக்கு 3D இப்போ ஆப்பர்ச்சுனிட்டிஸ் இல்ல நிறைய பேர் இப்ப 3D அப்படின்னு போறாங்க இப்ப 2D போறது பெட்டரா 3D போறது
கேட்டா எப்படி சொல்றது என்ன சொல்றது 2D போறது பெட்டரா 3D போறது பெட்டரா சொல்லுங்க
இல்ல மேம் 2D அனிமேஷன் இப்போ ஒரே ஒரே இதுல தானே மேம் போக முடியும் 2D 3Dன்னு ரெண்டுத்தையும் இது பண்ண முடியாது ஏதாவது ஒண்ணுத்துல போறோம்னா அதோட இதுதான் நம்ம ஃபுல்லா இது பண்ண முடியும்
ஏய் அப்படியெல்லாம் ஒண்ணும் இல்லப்பா யாராச்சும் உங்ககிட்ட நீங்க எல்லாமே பண்ணக்கூடாதுன்னு சொன்னா அது மட்டும் கேட்டுறாதீங்க ஐ யூஸ் டு பி அன் ஆர்டிஸ்ட் நவ ஐ அம் எ கேம் டிசைனர் ஐ ஆல்சோ டு ஃபேஷன் டிசைனிங் மல்டிபிள் திங்ஸ் நெவர் லிசன் டு தோஸ் பீப்பிள் டு வாட் எவர் யூ டு அஸ் மச் அஸ் யூ கேன் அண்ட் சோ 2D போறதா 3D போறதான்னு கேட்டா ஐ டோன்ட் ஹேவ் அன் ஆன்சர் ஃபார் இட் பட் இஃப் யூ கெட் பிகம் அன் எக்ஸ்பர்ட் இன் சம்திங் இப்போ நீங்க எனக்கு 2D தான் பிடிச்சிருக்குன்னு சொல்லிட்டு 2Dல நீங்க இறங்கி வர்க் பண்ணீங்கன்னா somebody will you will hit a peak right you will become an expert in it so you will be good at it similarly with 3D none of these two things are going to die 2D is still happening in games also right anime is also there they are applying 2D kind of a look to 3D also so neither will ever I don't think either will die it's all about what you love to do and what you want to become an expert in
Okay,
the balance, I guess. Yeah. Did that answer your question or was I just very...
Yes.
Okay, great. Thank you. No more questions, but then I think somebody asked a question about I studied a novel and the author used to take us in that place. Do we need to do same thing in storyboard? Totally. Storyboarding is all about taking that director into that world and making them understand how much in depth that story and the movie is all about. You have to take them into that world. From storyboard, get go, you will have to do that. And that's why all of these little angles and audios and BGM and things like that is quite important. You're welcome.
I think we have to close the session now since it's time. So now I hand over the session to Ms. Saranya, who will deliver the vote of thanks.
Yeah. So good afternoon. On behalf of the Department of Visual Communication, College of Science and Humanities, SRM Institute, Science and Technology, Vadapalli Campus, I take this opportunity to propose the vote of thanks to all who have helped us in making this workshop such a resounding success. Special thanks to our resource person, Raisa, to take out time from her busy schedule to grace the entire workshop. And we're really enlightened with your knowledge and presence. Thank you. I would like to express my gratitude to the management, Director Academic, Dr. K. Subbaram, SRM IST Vadapalani Campus, a Dean, Dr. K. Anantha Padmanabhan, CSH, SRM IST Vadapalani Campus, and the head of the department, Dr. V. Rajamani Shekharan, along with her beloved faculties. I must thank the students, event team, and designing team, and also the students of Visual Communication Department for their active participation. You have made this, you know, entire event more enthusiastic. Thank you, everyone, once again, for making it very insightful.
I just wanted to say that I had a lovely time. I was quite nervous, but you all made it very comfortable for me. And yeah, I had a great time. So I hope it was helpful. And please reach out to your professor if you have any questions anymore at all. I would love to help you all out. It was great. This was really fun.
Thank you. Thank you, Raisa.
Okay. I'll leave then. Take care. Bye.
மியூட்டே பண்ணும். Thank you.